Good morning. Welcome to Redeemer Lutheran Church and to this service, the Christian memorial service to commemorate the eternal victory of Odean Olsen. We'll follow the order of worship today that you'll find in your printed service folder, and our worship begins today with our opening hymn, hymn number 197. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Unto our God, who alone has immortality, be honor and power, both now and evermore. Make haste, O God, to deliver me. Make haste to help me, O Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Hymn 241. Thank you. man that is born of woman is a few days and full of trouble. He comes forth like a flower and is cut down. He flees like a shadow and does not continue. Behold, you have made my days as a handbreadth, and my age is as nothing before you. Truly, every man at his best state is altogether vanity. Thus says the Lord, dust you are, and to dust you shall return. For by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin. And so death passed upon all men, for all have sinned. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who has loved us and has given everlasting consolation and good hope to us through his grace, and has begotten us again to a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Being delivered for our offenses, he was raised again for our justification and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Our Lord Jesus is the first fruits of them that sleep. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Thanks be to God. The psalmody for today, Psalm 23, which I invite you to join in reading together with me. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The first lesson chosen for this occasion is written in the prophet Isaiah in the 53rd chapter, Isaiah chapter 53, verses 1 through 10. It's written, who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, and no beauty that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And as one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away, and as for his generation, who considered that he was cut off from the land of the living and stricken for the transgression of my people? And they made his grave with the wicked and with a rich man in his death, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him. He has put him to grief. But he makes his soul an offering for guilt, and he shall see his offspring. He shall prolong his days, and the will of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My soul, the Lord is mine.
The Holy Gospel lesson chosen for this occasion, St. John chapter 10, verses 7 through 18. And as you are able, I invite you at this time, please to rise and honor the gospel of our Lord Jesus. It's written, and the Lord Jesus said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is a hired hand and not a shepherd, who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees, and the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own. My own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock and one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down. I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. Hymn 401, verses 1, 2, and 3.
Thank you.
Odean Alfred Olsen was born on February 24th of 1930 to Ole and Alma Olsen in Divide County, North Dakota. He was born again of water and the Spirit in Holy Baptism on April 27th of that year and confirmed in the Lutheran faith on June 10th of 1945. He married Mary Ellen Olsen with an O on February 2nd of 1957, and together they raised three children. Odean served in the U.S. Army in Korea, where he was awarded the Purple Heart, and afterward, he worked as an import specialist for the United States Customs Service until his retirement in 1990. In retirement, he and Mary Ellen traveled and lived in Minnesota, Florida, and here in Arizona. Odean entered into eternal life on May 24th of 2023. He was preceded in death by his parents, his 12 siblings and their spouses, and his son Mark. He's survived by Mary Ellen, his wife, daughter-in-law Deb, children Lilas and Amy, married to Jerry, grandsons Brian, married to Jennifer, and Robbie, married to Sabrina, Skylar, Zachary, great-grandchildren, Eli, Reese, and Charlotte. Blessed be his memory. In the name of Jesus, dear friends and family, and especially you, Mary Ellen, with your children, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. The Bible is a very dear book, and yet there are some parts and pieces of it, passages in it, that become very special and very familiar and very dear. This service, as it turns out, is full of them. A lot of the things that I think Odean had in mind, you know, and that we got the chance to talk through together. One of the passages that's really precious and very dear to me is one written in Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, behold, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As a shepherd seeks out his flock when he is among his sheep that have been scattered, so will I seek out my sheep, and I will rescue them from all the places where they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. The Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he is faithful. He always keeps his word. And that is why we are here today. And not off on our own to try and figure out a way for ourselves to deal with grief. Not off to try and make sense of things by ourselves. Much less gathered to one of the world's idols that have eyes but can't see, ears but can't hear, right? And a mouth but can't speak. This image, on the other hand, the image that kind of ties together our service today, the image of a shepherd with his sheep, that image has power and meaning, and that goes way back in the scriptures, precious in the Bible and precious among those people who believe in Jesus. Ever since Abel, the shepherd, offered a sacrifice to God and God was pleased with it, Cain killed him for it. And then Moses, who was one time prince of Egypt, then he went from keeping flocks to bringing God's people out of slavery. And David was a shepherd who became king, and the Holy Spirit spoke through him in the psalm we heard this morning, Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. And if the Lord is my shepherd, what corresponds to that, you guys? But I am his sheep. And your loved one knew it, knew the words by heart, and we prayed it together in the last days and hours of his life. And what was happening was goodness and mercy were following him, chasing him. And he gathered to it, and feasted on Christ, and drank from his overflowing cup. Mary Ellen, I can't thank you enough for calling. What a joy and what a blessing. And everyone ought to live and die like this, by faith in Jesus. The thing is, being a sheep doesn't sound all that flattering to us, does it? Sheep will wander. Sheep go astray. Sheep put themselves in harm's way. Sheep don't worry about it much until something startles them, and then they will shake and they will bleat. Sheep can gorge themselves to death. And a sheep can sometimes get itself flipped over and it can't right itself. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. And God helps us to sort all these things out. He sorts it out for us. Why it is that this world that we live in is so beautiful and so wonderful and somehow still so messed up. How it is that we are so fearfully and wonderfully made, and yet somehow we die. We have heavenward hopes, but somehow we're bound to the earth. The truth of it is, and Odean knew this, we were made to live. And when we, God's creation of humanity, when we sinned and chose death instead, it is the Lord Jesus who said, the gospel lesson we heard for today, I have come that they may have life and have it to the full, have it abundantly. You guys, I know what it's like to lose a loved one. And my heart goes out to you today. I want to assure you that it is not the Lord come to steal and kill and destroy. The thief does that. It is the Lord Jesus who loves and gives life. No matter what we have to go through or lose in this life or how long our trials are going to last, your loved one had a blessed and happy life. And that life, which is in God, in Christ Jesus, he still lives. And as far as Odean's life in this world, I won't presume to tell you about it. The truth is, I would be happy to hear about it from all of you. As you share your memories with each other, as you laugh with each other, as you remind one another of how blessed you are to have such a great man in your life. He was a wonderful guy. In all of this, I would love to hear your memories as you share them, and I hope that you will. I've got a great little book that I borrowed from you, full of his memories. That is a good book. There's some wonderful things in there. But the truth of the matter is the life that is for us is in God. And if death comes to us, and if it comes to all of us, if this is what happens to the best of us, how can we live? But Jesus says, I am the good shepherd, and the good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. And then I shall not want. Then he makes me to lie down in the green pastures of his word. Then he provides me with the quiet waters of his wonderful forgiveness and grace. Because we all have sinned. But God has, did you hear it today from the Old Testament prophets? The Lord has laid on him, on Jesus, the iniquity of us all. And as for him, as for the Lord Jesus, it turns out that this work of shepherding is costly after all. Turns out it's dangerous and it's painful. Sheep love to stray, stumble into deep ravines and break legs, and the wolf is close by. And us, and Odean, and you and me, under the weight of sin, condemned and lost forever, that is what the good shepherd could not bear to see. And so, like a true shepherd, a good one, he came, ran to us, and he stepped in with his whole self. Our Lord God made man for us and for our salvation, because sin was too much for us, but Jesus took the blame for it. Death was too great for us, but Jesus gave himself up to it in our place. And the wolf was too cunning and too swift and too strong. The good shepherd put himself into the wolf's jaws for you and for me. And this is what's written in the scriptures, that God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. That is by faith. Because the opposite of doing something for yourself is to trust that someone else has got this for you. And that is Jesus for you. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. And he, risen and living, has this for you. And that is everything for people like us. And my poor soul and my eternity are staked on it too, because I guess you guys know I make mistakes. I guess you guys know that I am a fallen and sinful and dying person too. My poor soul has been helped by handling the words of Jesus and the gifts of Jesus, and by bringing them and seeing the wonderful example of Odean, which I will be so bold as to call him my friend. The wonderful example of his faith and joy and hope. And just as the Lord Jesus said, I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. If there's one thing a sheep has going for it, it's in the ears. Odean knew the voice of Christ, and he spoke back to Jesus in the prayers and the hymns and the songs of the church. And Odean made it easy for me today, because he picked all the hymns we're singing, every last one. Those were all his choices. And there's not a clunker in the bunch. In Christ, death is a short sleep that Jesus is going to break easily when he comes. Meantime, the soul is at home with God in heaven, and the body rests secure until that day. And so, we are sad, but only for us. And we grieve, but not like we have no hope. And it is only goodbye for now, but I will see you again, and even I'll see you soon. And we pray, come quickly, Lord Jesus. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Please join with me in making common confession of the holy Christian faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. They're in the older form. They're provided for you in the bulletin. We confess the faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. Hymn 553, please note the stanzas 1 and 3. O Lord Almighty, everlasting God, we thank you that you've given your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into death for us, and that through his triumphant resurrection, you've given us assurance of eternal life. We beseech you to comfort and raise us up with this assurance, and at last let us come to eternal rest with you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. The final hymn that Odean picked, hymn 554, verses 1 and 2 and 6. Receive the benediction. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Amen.